Good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. You may have noticed in this part of spreadsheet that you are at times asked questions about things that you have not been taught about so far or about which you haven't learnt earlier. However, you are being provided the answers also to such questions. This is because now you are studying about the advanced part of spreadsheet. You will be discussing options that you would have studied about in the basic part. Let us begin today's class now. Can you tell if you want to know the days of the month, then how will you get to know the same? To know the days of a month, you will use the formula equal to days in month. Can you tell what formula will I need to use if I want to find out the results of students to know who has passed and who has failed? For doing this, you will use the if formula, like equal to if bracket begin test value semicolon then value semicolon otherwise and then close the bracket, and will then be able to get the result of students who have passed and who have failed. If you want to find out how many weeks are there in the whole year, then which formula will you use? To find out the number of weeks in a year, you will need to use the weeks in year formula. The usage of which is equal to weeks in year and within bracket the date. Using this, you can find the number of weeks in a year. What is the difference between compare document and the changes option? Using compare document, you can compare your current document with another document and you can accept or reject the comparison being shown to you. With the change option, you can record any changes happening in your document and then you can view all the changes that you have made. Later, if you want the changes that you had made should not get reflected in your document, then you can accept or reject these changes by selecting the option for the same. Can you tell what is the difference between paste and paste special? By using paste, you can copy or cut any text, object or cell and paste it at another place as is. With the paste special option, you can give a command such that you can decide how you want to paste your data. If you want to paste only the text, then you can choose a command that will allow you to paste only the text. Similarly, you may choose to paste only the objects, rows or columns, etc. by using the paste special command. If you want to know the details of your current document, then how will you do this? To get to know these details, you will use the properties option of the file menu and you can get all such details of your spreadsheet document. Now, all of you switch on your computers and using any of the methods taught to you, open your spreadsheet document. Now, what you are going to learn today? Today, you will learn about the remaining options of the view and insert menu, like data sources, navigator, link to external data, names, comments, picture, movie and sound, object and floating frame. And after this, you will learn about some formulas. Now, all of you look at the data being shown to you and key it in one of the sheets of your spreadsheet. Before we move forward, let's us watch the video and review why we need to use the view option. And also review which options you have learnt about and also how you use them. You will also know which options you do not know about so far. With the help of this video, we are now going to see why we use the view menu and what all options are available in the view menu. So, when you want to view your CALCI sheet with different options, you will be using the view menu. So, for this, we need to take our pointer to the view menu. Click there. First option is normal, which is already there. If you click on page break preview, it shows you the page till where you have worked on it, till where you have typed on it. If you click on the file menu and click on page preview, you can see the page preview, which is also similar to what we have just seen. If you want to close the preview, you can just go here as is shown in the video and close that. If you want to bring back this view as normal view, you will go to the view menu, click on normal, and you will get the normal view back again. Once again, let's click on view menu to see the other options. We click here. Next is option for toolbars. So you can hide or show any of these toolbars. The ones which are tick marked here are the toolbars which are being shown right now. If we click on drawing toolbar, meaning we unselect it, you notice that the drawing toolbar is no longer shown to us. Once again, go to the view menu. If you click on status bar, the status bar also gets hidden. Let's again go to the view menu. If you want to hide the other toolbars also, for instance, if you click on formula bar, that means we are unselecting that, and the formula bar also gets hidden. Go back to view menu. From toolbars now, if we click on the formatting bar, the formatting bar also gets hidden. Again, going to toolbars in the view menu, if we click on customize, then we can customize the toolbars that we want to see. For instance, now in the standard toolbar, we are removing or unselecting the can't undo and can't restore, and click on OK. Then these two will also be gone from the standard toolbar. They are no longer available to you. Once again, going back to view menu, toolbars, if we click on the standard toolbar also will get hidden. So whichever toolbar we want, we clicked on the drawing toolbar, which means we selected it, it got shown. We clicked on the formula bar, it got shown. Like this, once again, if we go to the view menu, go to toolbars, and if we click or tick mark or select the formatting toolbar, for instance, we will get the formatting toolbar also. If it's not visible, you can just bring your cursor here and drag it a little bit. Click on status bar, the status bar appears. Go back to view menu and see the other options. The other option is the column and row header. If you unselect that, the column and row headers like the A, B, C, D and the 1, 2, 3, 4 that you were seeing as the headings for the rows have been hidden. Once again, if we go to the view menu, if we want to see this in the page preview, from the file menu you can see page preview, it's still not being shown. The column and row header are not there. Close the preview. If you want to bring back you can bring back by going to the view menu and clicking on the row and column header. So the column headers and the row headers are once again visible. You can see A, B, C, D and 1, 2, 3, 4 also. Once again, let's go back to the view menu. Look for the other options. The other option is value highlighting. If you select this, then any value which is available in your Calc sheet gets highlighted. As you can see here, the text is not highlighted, but any value which is there, any number which is there, gets highlighted. If you want to bring it back to the normal view, you go to view and tick mark again on the value highlighting and it comes back to normal view. Again, if you go to the view menu, you can see next option is for data sources. So it shows you the various data sources that you can use. In fact, the gallery has also opened. If you want to insert some data, you can use from these data sources. As is being shown in the video, in this case, one of the connections to the data source is not available. We just click on OK. If we want to close it, we again go to the view menu and click on data sources or unselect data sources. We can close the gallery option by clicking on these dots here. Go back to the view menu. The next is navigator. So in the navigator, you get this box. And for each row and column that you select, each cell that you select, it shows you what all options are available. The sheets, the range numbers, the database range. So you can see when you move in your file to a different cell, the column and row of that cell is shown. If you click on these icons, you can see different things happening. For instance, if you want to see only the sheets, you can click here. If you want to select one of these like graphics and want to see the what graphics has been used, you can see that also. Then the other icons here are for if you want to insert a hyperlink, you can use this, or if you have inserted a hyperlink, it will show you the various properties or information about that. Once again, we are back into our normal Calc sheet. Going back to the view menu, if you click on full screen, if you click on sidebar, on the right side, the sidebar that you are seeing gets hidden. So if you want to bring that sidebar back and want to see the information in the sidebar, you will have to go back to the view menu and once again select the sidebar. As soon as you select it, the sidebar becomes visible. The other option is for full screen. So go back to view menu, select the full screen option and you can see the sheet in full screen. If you click on the full screen button which is shown here, it will bring back the normal view. Once again, there is another option in the view menu which is for zoom. So if we tick mark on that, the zoom box opens. And you can use either fit width and height, fit the width, or if you want to use 100%, you can use that. Or if you want to you choose variable, you can choose what percentage you want to zoom up or zoom down. So this is how you can use the view option to view your sheet with different selections. Let us now learn about the remaining options of the insert menu. Can you tell why do we use the link to external option? Using this option, you can provide a link on your current document to your HTML, Calc or Excel files or sheets, and then you can use it as per your requirements. Let us now watch the video and see how this option is used. Let us now watch this video and learn how we use the link to external data. So first of all, on the sheet one, we have some data which is already there. We are going to select this entire data on the sheet one, and then we go to the insert menu, click there, and then click on the names option and click on define option in this. When you click on define, you can name this data that you are defining or saving. So we are going to type a name for this. We are going to call it computer 1. Once we have typed the name, we will click on the add button so that this data gets defined as computer 1 for us. Now this is defined. Click on OK. Come back to our sheet. Now if we want to take this data on sheet 2. So let's see, sheet 2 right now is a blank sheet. And we can use the insert option, insert menu. Click here. And now we will click on link to external data. When we click on link to external data, first of all, click on the drop down button which is shown in the box, because our file was in the untitled zone. So now if we look for our title, our file which we had saved, which was computer 1, it is not there. So we have to close this file once and then reopen it. So we can go back to the desktop, and from this untitled one, we just open that. We open our CALSI file that we were working on. We can close the message, and now sheet 1 has this data already. Sheet 2 is a blank sheet. So now we go to insert option, insert menu, and click on link to external data. Once again, click on the drop down button and go to the untitled file where we have saved our data. So we have to look for computer 1, which is here. Select that and then click on OK. You will see that this data now appears like a copy of the data which we had on sheet number 1. So this is how you can use the link to external data. Now you can see the same data on sheet 1 and sheet 2. So you can use this like copy paste option also. You can use this for many sets of data. Can you tell what is the names option and why is it used? With the names option, you can define the names for separate sections of your spreadsheet document. You can even use your name for selected cells so that later you can insert these cells data with the name you have given. Let us now view the video and see how this option is used. With the help of this video, we are now going to see how we can use the name option in the insert menu to define values for any of our cells in the CALSI sheet. So for this, we have some data already in sheet 1. Go to insert, go to name, and the first option here is define. So first we have to select the data which we want to define. So let's select this data here. We are selecting just the title row, the first row. Go to insert, go to names, click on define, and now you can give a name for the data. So we are giving the name CS1. However, when we try to add this, it shows that there is an error because it's invalid. The numeric should not be there. So we just type the name as CS. Click on add and then click on OK. Now this has been defined. Now if you go to sheet 2 and on one of the cells here, we want to use insert menu, go to names, and then click on insert option. So here you can look for the definition that you had created, which was CS. Click on OK, and you can see like a formula is there. If you click on it, shows the value on your Calci sheets. Next, let's select, go to insert again, go to names and create. So when we create, we are choosing top row and left column. But when we do an OK here, you will notice that it is not working because we have not selected the data. So it shows that there is invalid selection. So we first need to select the data on which we are working. So we have now selected the entire data. Go to insert, go to names, go to create. And now we have set top row, left column. So the names column will come and we click on OK. Since we had already created it, it's asking, do you want to replace? We just say yes. So we replace the existing data. For all the names, it is asking us, do you want to replace it? So we are saying yes to all. So all the names you can see are appearing here. And once it is completed, we have defined for all the names now. When we go to sheet 3, which is a blank sheet, go to insert, go to names again, and now we click on insert. Here you can see all the names are appearing. Names of all the students or all the people that they were there are appearing here. So if we click on one of these names, for instance, we are clicking on Kritika, click on OK. So it shows like a value. If you click there, it shows, it gives you the subject area of Kritika, which is management. If you extend this, you will also see the salary and the location. So this way you have used this cell for getting all the values related to that particular name. So now if we are just dragging it, or the same data is being repeated. So if we select the data again in sheet 1, go to insert, go to names, and click on labels. Now you can create labels. You can give them labels. So you can choose contents column label. So you can see in your sheet it is being applied. If you choose contains row labels, it will be shown in the rows in your sheet. Click on add, and you can see that the rows label has been added. Click on OK. Once again, if you go to the sheet which you were working on. So this way we can use the name option to define a value for a cell and then use it in our Calci sheets. Do you know why is the comments option used? With the comments option, you can give any comment about the cells of your spreadsheet and can also give your reaction or feedback for the same. These comments can then be viewed in the spreadsheet page margin. Let us now watch the video and see how this option is used. In this video, let us see how we can use the comments option. You can use the comment to give a comment for any cell on your Calci sheet. So you first need to select one of the cells. For instance, we have selected this D1, the location cell. And we go to the insert option, click on comments, and a comment box opens. You can type any comment that you want to give about this cell. For instance, we can type location itself, so that you know that the location has to be typed in this area. And once you click on the outside, this comment is no longer visible, but there is a red mark on the top right of this cell. If you click there and right click on it and click on show comment, the comment is shown again. Similarly, you can put a comment on any other cell. We've selected this cell. Once again, go to insert, go to comments. Comment box opens, You can write any comment about this. For instance, we want to write computer or computer shiksha for this name Sanju. So we are typing computer shiksha, and once you click on the outside, anywhere else, this comment is shown as a small red mark, and if you click, right click on it and click on show comment, the comment is shown to you again. If you select the comment box, you can go ahead and edit the comment that you had made. For instance, we want to change, so we have once again shown, gone back to the comment, and we can edit this comment also. So instead of location, now we are writing CS. So once again, if you want to delete the comment, you click on it on the cell, right click on it, and then use delete comment, as is also being shown in the video for both the comments. Next, you will learn about picture, movie and sound, object and chart. Since you have learned about these options in Writer and in Impress, we will now just watch the video and learn and review how these options are used in spreadsheets. Let us now watch this video to see how we can use the other options of Insert Meno for picture, movie and sound, chart and object on our Calc sheet. This is something which we have already learned in Impress. So we click on Insert, click on Picture, click on From File, and the location where your pictures are, you can go there. Select that location, select the picture you want, click on open, and wherever your cursor was or which cell you had selected, a picture gets inserted, that picture which you have selected. Now this picture you can resize using these green dots which appear on the side. You can move it and place it wherever you want, and you can resize it. You can give it a size that you like on your Calc sheet and insert it. So this way you can insert pictures on your Calc sheet. You can place it even on the top of data, but then the data is not visible. So you can place it wherever you like it. Then if you go to Insert, click on the movie and sound option, it again gives you where your movie and sound option is. So if we click on videos for looking at our videos, and we click on the sample video which is for wildlife, click on open, then that video gets inserted at the place where your cell was selected on the Calc sheet. So you can see that video has been inserted here. Once again, you can resize this movie and sound, this video, according to your need on the Calc sheet. And you can see that you can also drag it and place it wherever you like. So this way you can insert, we've already learned about inserting pictures, and this way we are also inserting a video. When you click on it, it gets selected. So you can do the operations of resizing, of moving it, dragging it and placing it at a location of your choice on your Calc sheet. You can see this happening in the video. You can use the scroll bars on the right and the bottom of your sheet to see the full video which you have inserted. Now let's go to sheet 1. We have some other data. Sheet 2, we have this data. To see, we have just cleared this sheet, sheet 2, by selecting and going to delete. Since the outline was there, we have removed that also. Now we have selected department and salary from sheet 1, some data. we go to sheet 2 and we are just pasting that data. We are just copying, pasting that data. Now we want to create a chart out of this data. So we select this data, go to insert Meno and click on the chart option. We will also be using the object option later. Let's first look at how we make a chart for this data that we have selected. So we need to click on the chart option. And you can see that a chart appears. Also, the chart wizard, the box is shown. Here, the first is chart type. So you can choose the type of chart that you want. Column or bar chart or pie chart, any of these. If you want to give it 3D, you can click on 3D look. So you can see that it becomes 3D and you can choose the shape that you want, box, cylinder. If you click on next, it is data range. So since we had already selected the data range, we don't need to use this. We can select data series in rows or data series in column. And accordingly, the chart will change. Click on next. It is the selection for data series. Again, you have the for salary, the range is there. So it is already selected. If you click on next, the chart elements are shown. So you can give it a title. You can give it a subtitle. If you want to write something along the x-axis, along the y-axis or the z-axis, you can write those things here. And if you look at the display legend, where do you want to display the legend? On the left, on the right, top or bottom? So if we select right, you can see when we click on finish, this chart is being shown. When you select it, these dots will appear, the green dots will appear. You can again use these to resize and move this chart to wherever you want to place it. Next, go back to insert option. This time let's use the object and we select the OLE object. As you already know from Impress, if you can, when you select OLE object, this box opens. And if you select, let's say, OpenOffice presentation, click on OK, then you have now an Impress slide or an Impress file available to you in your Calci sheet itself. So you can use this and create a slide, work on this slide. So if we click on outline option, for instance, here, it will show you the outline. And if you want to write something in front of this, you can write that. So you are creating a slide here within your Calci sheet. So this way, if you click on it, you can hide it or show it depending on what you want to do. So this way, you can use the various options in the insert Meno for pictures, for videos, movie and sound, and charts and objects. You will learn about the remaining options of the format Meno. Can you tell why do we use the format Meno? With the format Meno, you can format your spreadsheets in different formats, just like you can do the character formatting or do the page formatting. You can also use auto format option. There are other options also which you can use with the format Meno. Can you recall which all options you have learnt about for the format Meno? You have earlier learnt about the options of the format Meno, like default formatting, cell, row, column, sheet, change case, auto format, conditional formatting, etc. Now you will learn about anchor, alignment, arrange, flip, group, etc. Can you tell what is the alignment option? Using the alignment option, you can keep your sheet's data on the left, right, center, top, etc. of the cell. Let us watch the video and see how the alignment option is used. To use the alignment option, you need to take your pointer to Format menu, click on Alignment, and then there are various types of alignments: default, top, bottom, right, left, and so on. We select one of the cells on which we want to use the alignment. We have just increased the width of this column so that you can see the change in alignment. Right now, all this data is aligned towards the right. We go to Format, go to Alignment, click on Left, and you can see that the cell which was selected has been left aligned. The data has gone towards the left margin. Go to Alignment again. If you use Center, you can see that the data goes to the center. If we select all the data in this column, go to Alignment, select Right, all of the data has been right aligned. Once again, if you go to the Format menu, click on Alignment and choose one of the options here, for instance, Justify, it makes all the data come towards the left side. Let us now see how we can use the top, center, and bottom alignments. So for that, we need to have a cell where some data we type. We have typed in this cell, we are typing A, and we just make the font very small so that you can see this letter A being moved up and down. Now we select this A, the cell where A is written. Go to Format, go to Alignment, and select Top. So you will see that the letter A goes to the top of this cell. Again, go to Format, go to Alignment, select Center, and you can see the letter A appears in the center. Once more, using Format, going to Alignment, we click on Bottom, and the letter A appears at the bottom of the cell. So this is how you can use the alignment option to align your data either to the top, left, right, center, like, or any way that you want. Can you tell why is the arrange option used? With the arrange option, you can keep your objects in different orders. Like, you can set your object as the cell's background and above the cell also. Let us now watch the video and see how the arrange option is used. Let us watch this video now and see how we can use the arrange option to arrange our objects or clip art pictures. You can use arrange for clip art pictures and objects on your Calci sheet. So you can set them as the background or you can bring them on top. Let's see how it is done. We first go to another sheet where we have already inserted. We go to sheet 1 where we have inserted an image. We select that image, and if we want to take this into the background, we will go to the Format menu, click there, and go to Arrange. You have Bring to Front, Forward 1, Back 1, Send to Back, or To Background. So if we click on To Background, you will see that the picture appears in the background and the cells are shown on top. Now you can enter any text in your cells and it will be there. You can see it. So you can either get the picture in the background or bring it in the foreground, as has been shown to you by using the arrange option. Can you tell what happens with the flip option? Using the flip option, you can rotate objects. This is of two types, horizontal and vertical. Let us see this video and see how the flip option is used. Let us watch this video now and see how the flip option is used. Flip is used for any object or drawing or picture on your Calci sheet. For this, on the sheet 2, we are just inserting a triangle using the drawing toolbar, as you can see in the video. Now we select this triangle, take our cursor to the format menu bar, click on it and click on flip, and click on flip object vertically. So you can see that this triangle has been flipped or rotated vertically. If we click on flip horizontally, you will see the image gets horizontally flipped. This is how you can use the flip option. The next option is of group, using which you can make a group of any of your pictures and clip art. Once these are part of a group, you can select all of them in one go. Let us now watch the video and see how the group option is used. Let us watch this video now and see how we use the group option. To group two or more objects, we first need two objects. So we are using the drawing toolbar to draw two objects, as is being shown in the video. Now you can see when we select any of these objects, they get selected individually. If we want to group them so that both these objects get selected together, we first have to use the shift key, press the shift key down and select both the objects one by one. Then go to format option, group and select group option. Now when you do anything or select any one of these objects, the entire group or all the objects in that group get selected. So you can see we can move one of these objects, the second object will automatically move. When we format or we have just changed the color of the outline, both the lines have got outline changed. Then we are changing the inside color. We've used bitmap and we've used the brick option, and you can see both have got changed. Both the formats have got changed. Again, if you are moving them, they are moving together. Now if you want to go back to normal so that individual objects are selected, go to format, go to group and select ungroup. So you can see now both these objects, if you select them individually, they can get selected individually. And if you do any work on any of these objects, it will be done only on that object. Now let's see if we want to group them again, we will select one and go to format and go to group, but you see none of the options are highlighted. This is because the second object has not been selected. So we have to use the shift key and select the second object also. Then go back to format, go to group option, and then use group. So again, once again, these two objects have become part of a group. Now if we go to format again, group and ungroup, it also gets, these objects get individually ungrouped, so they don't become part of a group. So you can move them, select them and work on them. This is how you will use the group option. Next, you will learn about many formulas like SUMIF, SUMIFS, COUNTIF, COUNTIFS, LARGE, SMALL, AVERAGE IF, AVERAGE IFS, and about MATCH formula. Now, first type out the data shown in front of you on your spreadsheet document. Let us now learn about the COUNTIF formula. Can you tell why we use the COUNTIF formula? You will use the COUNTIF formula when from the given data, based on a certain condition, you want to count it from a row or column. The formula for this is equal to COUNTIF, begin bracket, test range, semicolon, condition, and close the bracket. Watch the video and see how the COUNTIF formula is used. Let us now watch this video and see how the COUNTIF formula is used. We already have some data on sheet 1. So let's use this data to apply the COUNTIF formula. So we can just select all this data, copy paste it, and let's use a new sheet. So after sheet 3, we can insert a new sheet. We go here and double click on it, and then we can say insert a new sheet after the current sheet. So we have a new sheet. We can paste our data here as is being shown in the video. Now we want to see with one condition, for instance, in the department, if there is an engineer, how many engineers are there? If you want to count that number, we can use the COUNTIF formula. So what we are going to do is we are going to look at different departments. So we first copy paste the department title here. You can copy this, use shortcut method Ctrl plus C and paste it here, Ctrl plus V. And then since we want the different departments, there are 5 different departments, and we can copy paste these 5 different departments here as is being shown in the video. Now we want to see how many engineers are there. So we will use the COUNTIF formula. So we first type the title here, COUNTIF, and then we will find out how many engineers are there in this list, how many doctors, how many scientists. So we first type the title, COUNTIF, and then in the next cell we apply the formula equal to COUNTIF, then it asks for range, begin the bracket. So the range is all the departments which are there. So we will select that range. As you can see in the video, we select this range here. And now we also will freeze this so that things don't move, things don't change. So we can use Shift F4 to freeze this. Once this is done, put a semicolon, and then you have to give the criteria. So the criteria is engineer, because we are right now trying to count all the engineers in this particular data. So we select the engineer criteria, select that, close the bracket, and then press enter. And you can see it shows you that there are 4 engineers in this list, which is also right. Now if you want to apply the same formula for doctor, scientist, management, finance, you can just double click on the black dot, or click on the black dot and drag downwards, and you will get the answers for how many doctors are there, scientists, management, finance people. So all of them, the rest are all 3. This is how you will use the COUNTIF formula for one condition. Can you tell why is the COUNTIF formula used? You will use the COUNTIF formula when from the given data you want to get the count from a row or column based on 2 or more conditions. The formula you will use for this will be equal to COUNTIF, begin bracket, range 1, semicolon, criteria 1, semicolon, range 2, semicolon, criteria 2, semicolon, and so on, and then close the bracket. Let us see this video and see how we can use the COUNTIF formula to count certain conditions more than two or more than two conditions. So in this, we already have one condition is the department, and let's select the other condition to be the location. So we've just copy pasted the title location, and we know that there are five different locations also: Delhi, Pune, Mumbai, Bangalore, Gurgaon. We copy paste that also. Now in the next cell, we are going to apply the COUNTIFS formula using these two conditions. For instance, we want to find out how many engineers are there who are staying in Delhi and how many doctors are there who are staying in Pune. Similarly, how many scientists are there in Mumbai, management people in Bangalore and finance people in Gurgaon. So we use the COUNTIFS formula equal to COUNTIF, begin the bracket, and then it says select the first range. The first range is our department, so we select the department column. As you can see in the video, we are selecting the department column. Then put a semicolon and give the first criteria. The first criteria is that the person should be an engineer. So we select engineer. Once again, we put a comma. The second criteria is the location. So we select that. Then put a semicolon again and put the criteria. And we want the criteria to be Delhi. So right now we're looking for engineers in Delhi. Close the bracket, press enter. And you can see there is one engineer in Delhi in the entire list. So if we double click on this or drag it downwards, you can see that the doctors in Pune, there are two. Scientists in Mumbai, there are two. Management people in Bangalore, one. Finance people in Gurgaon, one. So like this, you can use the COUNTIFS formula to count the number of engineers in different or departments in different locations. You will learn about the SUMIF formula. Using the SUMIF formula, you can use the name and any other condition to get the sum or the total of the given data. For this, the formula is equal to SUMIF, begin bracket, range, semicolon, criteria, semicolon, sum range, and close bracket. Let us now watch the video and see how the SUMIF formula is used. Let us now watch this video and understand how we use the SUMIF formula. For instance, if we want to see the total salary of all the engineers, we can use the SUMIF formula. So first we want to insert a column just before the location column. So we go to column, go to insert, and we go to columns, insert columns before the H column. So we have inserted a column before the location column. Now here we are going to see the sum of all the engineers' salary. Similarly, all the doctors' salary, scientists' salary, like that. So we are going to use the SUMIF formula to do this. As we already know, there are four engineers. There are three doctors, three scientists, three management, three finance persons. So in the H column, we are going to use the SUMIF formula. So we first will write SUMIF as a title. Then in the next cell, let's apply the formula, which will be equal to SUMIF, then begin bracket. And it wants us to define the range. So since our range is from the departments, we will select that range. As is being done in the video, then put a semicolon and give the first criteria. The first criteria is that we are looking for engineers in these departments. So we select engineer. Put a semicolon, then you have to give the sum range. Now the sum you have to do is from the salaries. So we have to select the salaries range. So we select the salaries column, close the bracket and press enter. And you will see it shows us the amount of all the four engineers after adding them together. And now if we drag this black dot downwards, we will get the sum of the three doctors, the three scientists, their salaries. The same formula has been applied to all the professionals of all the people from different departments. If you just select these SUMIF totals, you can see the sum here, 239,000. If you want to add the salary total, you will find that same sum is appearing, 239,000. So this is how you can even cross check that you have applied the correct SUMIF formula. This is how you will use the SUMIF formula. The next formula is of SUMIFs. You will use this formula if you want to get the sum or total of your data using two or more than two conditions. You will use the SUMIFS formula for this. The usage of this formula is equal to SUMIFS bracket begin sum range semicolon range 1 criteria 1 after the semicolon, then semicolon again range 2 semicolon criteria 2 and so on, and close the bracket. Let us now watch the video and understand the use of these SUMIF formulas. We will watch this video now to see how we can use the SUMIFS formula, where we can apply more than one condition to get a sum of our desired value. So we are going to use this here in the K column. So we are writing the title here, SUMIFS. And then in the next cell, we will apply the formula equal to SUMIFS. Remember, now there is a S also, SUMIFS. So it asks for first the sum range. What is it that we want the total of? So since we are looking for the total of the salaries, we will select the salary column as the sum range. We are looking for all the engineers in Delhi and we want to get a total of their salaries. So since we are totaling the salaries, similarly we will total later on doctors in Pune, scientists in Mumbai, management personnel in Bangalore, finance personnel in Gurgaon. So let's first select the sum range. So the salary is our sum range. Put a semicolon. Then it says criteria 1. So the criteria 1 is, sorry, range 1. So first you have to give the range 1. So we are looking for the department. Since the engineer is part of this department, so we select the department column. Put a semicolon, then criteria 1. So we are saying we are looking for only engineers. So we select the engineer from here, as is being shown in the video. Put a semicolon. Then it says the criteria 2, the range 2, range 2. The range 2 now is that we are looking for locations. So we select the location column, put a semicolon, and the criteria 2 is that this engineer should be based in Delhi. So we select Delhi, close the bracket, press enter, and you will see that it will give you a total salary of the engineers in Delhi. Since the engineer in Delhi is only one and the salary is 60,000, you will see that the answer shown to us will be 60,000. So we have the total number of total salary of engineers in Delhi by this SUMIFS formula. Similarly, we can do for doctor, scientist, management personnel and finance personnel. Doctors, since there are three in Pune, it will show, if we ask for doctors in Pune, it will show us how much is the total salary for these three doctors. So let's apply this formula once again for the doctor. And then we can also copy or drag, as you know, drag down the formula which we have applied. But let's, for practice, let's apply this formula once again. So equal to sum ifs, begin bracket, which is shift 9, then the sum range. The sum range is the salary. So we select the salary column, semicolon, then it says range 1. So the range 1 is the department column. We select the department column, then semicolon, and the criteria 1. The criteria 1 is that the person should be a doctor. So we selected doctor, semicolon, then the range 2. The range 2 is the location. So after putting the semicolon, we have to select the range 2, which is the location column. So we select that, put a semicolon, and then give the criteria 2. The criteria 2 is that we are looking for a doctors in Pune. So we'll select Pune, and then we can close the bracket. If there are more conditions, we will apply like this only. Close the bracket, press enter, and you can see that the three doctors based in Pune earn 1,46,000. And if you drag this formula down, you will get the total salary for three scientists in Mumbai. You will get management people in Bangalore, three management people in Bangalore, their total salary, and three finance people, their total salary. So this is how you can use the sum ifs formula. You will now learn about the large and small formulas. With the help of the large formula, you can get the largest value from your sheet. The formula you will apply for this will be equal to large, begin bracket, numbers list, semicolon, n, bracket close. Using the small formula, you can find the smallest value from your sheet data. The formula you will use for this will be equal to small, begin bracket, number list, semicolon, n, close the bracket. Let us now watch the video and see how the large and small formula are used. Let us now watch this video and see how we can use the large formula to find out the second largest, third largest, and so on numbers from our data. As you can see, we already have some data in our CALCI sheet. For instance, if you want to find the maximum value from the salary, we can use the maximum formula. But to find the second largest, third largest, we can use the rank and we can use the large formula. So we are putting the rank here, we are just typing rank here as a title, and then we are typing rank 1, rank 2, rank 3, so that we can get the second largest, third largest, and so on salary details when we use the formulas. So for the maximum salary, to find out the rank number 1 salary or the highest salary, we use the maximum formula, which is equal to max, and then we select the number range. So we select the entire salary column and then press enter. So you see 750000 is the highest salary from amongst all the salary given. To find the next largest, we'll use the large formula. So rank 2, we use equal to large, begin bracket, and then select the data range. So the data range is the salary column. So we select that, and then we, since we want the rank, we put a semicolon and we put number 2 as the second rank or the second largest figure we want to find. When we close the bracket and press enter, you can see that the next largest value from the salary is given here, which is 560000. Now if we drag this down, you will notice that the same figure is repeated because we had asked for the second rank. However, if we want to use the same formula for finding out the third rank and fourth rank, we can do this in a different manner. So we type equal to large, begin bracket, select the range, which is the salary column, and then put a semicolon, and for the rank, and we freeze this, and then put a semicolon and select the rank, which is 2 here in this case, and then close the bracket. Now if you press enter, you get the second highest salary, and if you drag this formula for the third and the fourth rank, now you will get automatically the third highest and the fourth highest, or the third largest and the fourth largest figure from the salary column. So this is how we use the maximum and the large formula to find the second largest, third largest, fourth largest numbers from our data. By watching this video now, we will get to know how we use the small formula. So we use minimum formula to find the minimum from our data, and we use the small formula to find the next to the minimum. So the second minimum, third minimum, that way. Just like we had found maximum and used large, so we type minimum salary as a title in one of the cells here, and then here we in rank 1 we want to find out the minimum salary, so we'll use the minimum formula, which is equal to min bracket begin, and then select the data range, which is the entire salary column, close the bracket, and then press enter, and you will see that the minimum salary is 45,000 in the entire salary column. So that has been shown here. Now if you want to find the next minimum or the second rank minimum, we will use the small formula for this. So we'll use equal to small, begin bracket, and then select the data range, which is again the salary column. So we select that, put a semicolon, and then since we want to find the second rank, we'll select number 2 rank here like this, close the bracket and press enter, and you can find 60,000 is the next minimum or the second rank smaller salary or minimum salary. If we drag down this formula, you get the rank 3 and rank 4 small answers also. This is how you will use the small formula. The next formula is for average if. Can you tell why the average if formula is used? Using the average if formula, you can get the average from given data using one condition. The formula used for this is equal to average if begin bracket, range, semicolon, criteria, semicolon, average range, close the bracket. Let us watch the video and see how the use of the average if formula is made. Let us now watch this video and see how we use the average if formula. So we want to find, let's say, the average salary of all the engineers. Then we will use the average if formula. So since we are going to be looking for average salaries of each of the departments, we are just going to copy paste the departments here as is being shown in the video. And in the next column, we are just making it a little wider. And since we are going to use the average if formula, we will give it a title here. So we are going to type average if as a title here, because we are going to use the average if formula. Remember, average if formula is based on one condition. So based on one condition, it will find the average for engineers. For instance, our condition in this case would be engineers or doctors or scientists, management personnel, finance personnel. So let's apply the formula. So we write equal to average if, then begin bracket, then it says range. So our range is the departments. From all these, amongst all the departments, we are looking for the average of the engineers, doctors, so on. Then it says criteria. So our criteria in this, the first case is for engineers. So we select engineer from here, semicolon again, and then the range, average range from where we want to find the average. So that would be the salary column. So we select the salary and then close the bracket. Then you press enter and you will find that it has given you the average salary for the four engineers that are shown in this data. So that average is 189,000. Now if you want for the doctor scientist, since we have applied the formula, we can just drag this. You can see this. This is an average for 60,000, 71,000, 65,000 and 56,000. 560,000. So when you drag this, you also get the average salaries for doctor, scientist, management persons, finance person. So you can see that the average salaries based on this department condition has been found. Let us now learn about the average ifs formula. You will apply the average ifs formula to find the average from given data based on two or more than two conditions. Watch the video to understand how the average ifs formula is used. In this next video, we are going to now see how we use the average ifs formula for finding an average based on more than one condition from our data. So we want to find, for instance, an engineer who is located in Delhi and their average salary. So we are now applying two conditions. One is the department and the other is the location. So let's first, we already have a department column here. Let's also copy the location column here. So we'll just copy the locations which get repeated. So we just copy from Delhi, Pune, Mumbai, Bangalore and Gurgaon and paste it here. Once we have done this, in the next column, we are going to find out the average ifs formula. Based on two conditions, we are finding the average. So here we apply the formula, which will be equal to average ifs. Remember, there is an S also in this, average ifs, begin the bracket, and then it asks for the average range. So the average range is the salary column, because we want to find the salary average, then semicolon, and then it asks for range 1. So the range 1 would be the departments, from amongst all the departments. So we'll select the department column. Once again, semicolon, and then criteria 1. So the criteria 1 is, we are looking for engineers. So we select the engineer here, semicolon, then it says range 2. Now our range 2 is based on the location. Where is this engineer located? So we select the location column here. We will just select all the data in the location column. One more semicolon. And then the criteria for this is Delhi. So an engineer based in Delhi. For all the engineers based in Delhi, what is the average salary? So we select that, close the bracket, and then press enter. And you can see that the engineer based in Delhi, the salary is coming as 60,000. Now if you drag this down, you will get the average salary for doctors based in Pune, scientists based in Mumbai, management personnel based in Bangalore. Now in the 17th row, if we change this to an engineer who is also based in Delhi, you will notice immediately that the average if answer gets changed also. So this is how you can find the or use the average if formula based on more than one condition. We now learn about the match formula. Can you tell why is the match formula used? With the match formula, you can find a match for any value in your data. The formula used is equal to match, begin bracket, search criteria, semicolon, lookup array, semicolon, type, and close bracket. Watch the video to know more about how this formula is used. Let us now watch this video and learn about using the match formula and also the index and match formula together. So if you want to know the position of a particular type of data, for instance, here we have just copied engineer. Then we are looking for position. So we have typed the title position, and in the next cell, we are going to use the match formula. So that will be equal to match, begin the bracket, and then the search criteria. The search criteria is engineer. So we select engineer, and then semicolon, and then the lookup array. So the lookup array is from amongst these departments: engineer, doctor, scientist, management, finance. So we select these, and then the type. Type is 0. So because we want exact match, then close the bracket, and when you press return or press enter, you find engineer is at the first position. So now if you change the engineer, we copy paste management in the cell, the position of the management department will be shown, which is number 4. Again, if we change this to, let's say, scientist, we copy paste scientist in the cell, you will see automatically it shows number 3 as the position of the scientist. Similarly, we can delete the word scientist from here, and if you want, you can just type in doctor, and it will show you that the doctor position is number 2. So this way, match formula will give you the position of the particular thing that you're looking for. Now you can use match with index also. So in this sheet number 5, we have already got some data. You can also use the same data. This is for, let's say, employees with name ABCD, and some figure for them for each of these months: January, February, March. So now we have the name, which is ABCD, and we have the month. So we're just typing what all values we have in this data, and then we have a value for A in the month of January. The value is 67, as you can see in the table. Now, if you want to see these values, if you want, you can use the, we're going to use the index formula with the match formula also. To get match will give you the position and the index will give you the value for that. For instance, name we want A, month we want January, and then value we want to find by using the index formula. So we're going to apply the index formula here in this cell. So we type equal to index, begin bracket, and then it says reference row and column. So we select all these rows where the values can come from. And then it asks for, we put a semicolon and it says range. So now to give the range, we basically wanting to find the position. So we'll use the match formula here. So we will type match after the semicolon, begin bracket. And now it says search criteria. So our search criteria is the name. So we select A, then semicolon. Then the lookup array, is all the names A, B, C, D. So we'll select that data from A column, semicolon. And then it says type, which is 0 because we want exact match. Close the bracket. Then semicolon. Then once again, we'll use match because we want to use name and the month also. So we type match, begin bracket. This time the search criteria is, we select Jan, one of the months, then semicolon, and then the range for this or lookup array for this is the Jan, Feb, March. So the first row. So we select that, type is 0, close the bracket, and you can see the value it returns is 67. So for A in January, the value is 67. If we change the name to B, you will see the B in the month of Jan, that value is 56. Similarly, if we change it to D and also change the month also, you will find D in the month of Jan is 54. But if we change the month also, let's say we use March, it will return the month, the value as 90. And then also to find the values, as we have used the index to show the values from our data. Since this class ends here, all of you go ahead and save your file and then close the file and then properly shut down the computer. In today's class, you learnt about the remaining options of the view, insert, and format menus like navigator, names, comments, conditional formatting, alignment, and arrange. Besides this, you also learned about the formulas for COUNTIF, SUMIF, LARGE, SMALL, AVERAGEIF, AVERAGEIFS, MATCH, etc. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Thank you.